Guys, when you're trying to be prepared, there's just a lot of information out on the internet that, you know, really is conflicting in some ways. A lot of different philosophies, a lot of different experiences. And sometimes it's good to just kind of go by the standard. And so recently I picked up one of the Air Force Survival Kit medical modules. You should definitely have medical gears and supplies with you, especially in a, you know, grid down situation. And so we're going to take a look at what the Air Force uses in their survival kit to make sure that you have the items that you really need, because there's a lot of study that goes behind these kits and a lot of real world experience. Now, the kit comes vacuum sealed and it has a label on here. Here it has the NSN numbers, and then we have medical module. And then, of course, we have our expiration date and the date that it was produced. And this just expired April 2019. So this is the current medical module for the survival kit. Here there is a grommet at the top, so you can actually attach this. Now, one of the things before we get it open, this was $49.99 on eBay. But I did see some actually after I bought this one for about 34 bucks. You just kind of do your research if you're really wanting to get one of these. But guys, again, the main purpose for showing this, that your medical gear is up to par. So we're going to go ahead and open it up. We've got these tabs. Just going to pull it. And really, this is made for gross motor skills to be able to get this open. Now I was knocking all kind of stuff over to get this open. This actually, there we go. Boy, that was tough. It's sealed, that's for sure. Okay, now we have a inner seal as well. And this looks like same information right here. And then this is a Ziploc or a lock so we can keep this fresh. We're going to pull everything out. Now we have all the contents laid out. We have kind of medical, and then we have just personal hygiene, things like that. And we're going to take a look at each one. We're going to start out though with what's not necessarily medical. And the first we have is an SOS IR chem light. And this is actually 4 inches. It has a cord that's wrapped around it. But the great thing about this is it's not going to be bright as far as by the eye, but for a search and rescue, you can put this on you. And if they're using IR or night vision, they're going to be able to see this. And so this is just a really cool tool to be able to use, to be found for those who have the ability to be able to locate you. Next, we have the Ceralite 70. This is a lemon flavored drink. This is going to give you the electrolytes. And of course, this is a powder, and it is gluten-free, all natural. Gives you directions on the back. This will keep you hydrated. Next, they have some sunscreen protection. This is, of course, a lotion, and it's Sun-X 30 Plus. And so this is going to give you extreme protection from the sun. And then they have the Bug X 30. This is 30% DEET. It's an insect repellent towelette. So you can just open it up, and definitely insects are a problem in the outdoors, especially in the summertime. Then we have just a basic utility towelette. This is dry, and this is to wipe off sweat, perspiration, you know, things like that. And it's just a small little towelette. But then we have 4 of the moist towelettes, and these are antibacterial. So this is going to keep infection down. If you cut yourself, you can keep that wiped down with these towelettes. And we have 4 safety pins to be able to secure any kind of bandages if you're injured. And these are 2-inch safety pins, and they're the number 3. Now, as far as real medical, you have these large bandages. These are really just like large band-aids, and they're 2-inch by 4.5-inch, and there are 4 of them. And then we have just your standard band-aids, which are 1-inch by 3-inch, and there's 4 of those. We also have some bacitracin zinc ointment, and this is definitely for, you know, keeping infection down, and there's 2 packs of that. Then we have some quick clot combat gauze. This stuff is excellent. You know, it keeps, especially if you're bleeding pretty good, you can pack the wound with this and it will clot the blood. And this is really a big one, a lifesaver. And then we have the H&H flat compressed gauze. Great for packing wounds, great for, you know, whatever. I mean, this is a pretty large piece. It's 4.5 inches by 4.1 yards. So it's really long. I mean, if you break your arm, you need to have a splint, or you need to really wrap up something, you can do it with the H&H compression gauze. But again, this is great too for packing wounds and stopping bleeding. But you do have your combat gauze as well. Then we have the flat pack camo wrap, and this is a self-adhesive wrap, very similar to what guys in sports use to wrap their ankles or wrap their wrist. And this will cover up any kind of dressing that might show up, you know, if you're on an escape and evasion type situation. It's 2 inches by 2 yards, so you have a lot of material here. And so that's all the contents. When we finish, we can actually put it back into this Ziploc type bag, and it will keep it somewhat secure. Not as waterproof, obviously, as the original. And so if you do pick up one of these or a couple, you know, I would leave it in this packaging, and you can see what all you have right here. And that's really part of the purpose of this video. If you are interested in the, you know, actual Air Force survival, you know, medical module, you don't have to open it up. But if you do, you've got everything you can pack here. Now, I've gotten all the contents back in the bag. Again, it is a Ziploc bag, but one thing I want you to notice is that it does have holes on either side. And not sure exactly what the purpose of that is, maybe to hang this up, but this is not going to be waterproof, so you may want to get one of those Alok sacks to put this in, and that would keep it definitely secure. With the band-aids and some of the gauze and stuff, even though a lot of those are sealed, the band-aids aren't, and you want to make sure you keep this waterproof. So again, I would leave it in the original wrapping if possible. So guys, sometimes we just need to go back to the source and see what is really viable for medical and other things. Hopefully we'll be getting some different items that are U.S. military survival related and bring it to you that you can really be prepared and have the items you need if you ever are in a disaster or a crisis situation. Now, if you're serious about prepping and survival, check out Survival Dispatch Insider. It has some of the top names in the survival and prepping world. We upload one video exclusively to the Insider every week. There's a lot of information there, and I'll have a link down below in the description. Check it out. Be strong, be of good courage. God bless America. Long live the Republic. Knocking things over, good gosh. Now it's time to pack this back up. We're gonna put this in our pack.
I'll bet at the end of the video you wondered how I got all that stuff back in here. The magic of editing.